I met Joe at work. I had a brand new Camaro. He had a little Honda, I don't know. We were leaving work one day and he said, can I see your car? You know, the key seat car. So he wanted to sit in it. He took it. Took it around the corner at work and then drove up to me, threw his keys out and said, follow me. So I had to follow him. Followed him all the way home.
He told me on our first date he was going to marry me, that I would be a good mother. There was a competitiveness about him too. Like, I didn't let him win at Scrabble. Save his ass just to bug me. And
he will always make jokes with my older daughter that daddy's going after the bad guys. I'm gonna catch the bad guys. Cause they used to like watching superhero movies. So dedicated to everything that he did. So being a dad just made him, I guess it made him a better person, but he was already a great guy.
Oh, it's Easter week. Okay, I was a teacher, right? I was home. I said goodbye to him around 12 o'clock. He was going into work early. He was working for a friend. There was a routine fire. They use that word, routine fire, down by the Holland Tunnel. The fire had smoldered for a long time, but in went John and two young firefighters, Christopher Seidenberg and Jimmy Young. They hadn't even begun their lives yet. Nothing worked. They couldn't get water out of the hydrant. There was traffic by the Holland Tunnel. Holes were not put in the right place. And he had tried to knock through this big, heavy metal security door. It had been double bolted. He almost got it. Jimmy was dead. They didn't even recognize that he was a firefighter at first. Christopher died the next morning. John's burned over 65% of his body very, very deeply. Nobody expected him to live, you know, as he laid in the hospital those 40 days, except the people that knew him. They were doing the 12th surgery at the time he died. He would have had a really, really challenging life.
My father was a police officer. My husband's father was a fireman. His brother was a fireman. All our friends were cops and firemen. That was our life. Well, on September 11th, it was election day, school day. I put my two kids on the bus, Joe and Jim, and I came home with John. The FedEx guy told me that the Twin Towers was just hit by a plane. I immediately went into my sergeant, I said, I have to go into Manhattan. My husband's not answering the phone. My friend from the precinct, Susie, said, Commissioner Dunn is looking for you. So we went to police headquarters, and when I got there, my parents were there, my in-laws were there. That's when they told us that they were missing. They found Joe about October 18th or 19th. I sat the kids down and tell them that their father was dead.
My husband was part of the NYPD for 17 years. When COVID hit, I was very nervous about it. When he would come home, I would be spraying, asking him to take everything in the garage. One night, he told me that I think my partner had COVID, so I think I had been exposed. So I said, okay, so I'm gonna have to go with the girls so that you could have the whole house to yourself. And the whole time I watched him on FaceTime. He texted me one morning, he said, I can't get out of bed. His oxygen was still not where it needed to be for them to hospitalize him. He battled with COVID about two and a half weeks. I meditate and I think about my feelings and I cry if I need to. And then when I go to bed, I say, oh, there was purpose. Elena did this. Ella did that. Eric would have been so proud if he saw that. That gives me purpose to make their day go well. When Answer the Call gave me a call, I was still not home. I was still in a time of uncertainty. Like, what am I gonna do? Because my husband did everything for us. Life doesn't stop because of what you're going through. Things still have to get done. And as a mom, to know that Answer the Call is gonna be there for me through our lives now, it feels like I'm not alone.
You don't want to sit home and grieve. So the best therapy that I found was being with other people with the same circumstance.
When we went to the Mets game and Alina threw the first pitch, she's like, I threw the ball as hard as I could. She said, Mommy, did you hear them say Daddy's name? And she was so proud. Now it's funny how Elena and him used to go watch these superhero movies. They remind our kids that, hey, we remember your dad. Your dad was a hero.
It's different being the mother of a police officer because as an adult, they're still my children. They both want to do what their dad did. I'm just like living life to make sure that my kids are set. And I feel that Answer the Call did that for us when Joe died.
I remember looking at that first check, and I think it was for $10,000. And I looked at it, and I looked at it. I don't think I had ever seen so much money in my life. 27 years later, they still send me a lovely letter and a check to be used for my family as a symbol that John Drennan's life wasn't in vain. They have always, always remembered, and I'm most grateful for them.
Thank you for helping our family.
Thank you for never forgetting.
Thank you for answering the call.